Josh and Dean.
Fuck off.
Have brought out very different things in Rob and I.
I've slept for a long time, so that's good.
They're really spontaneous and exciting players and kind of ramshackle in quite a unhinged sort of way.
Is Josh on this tour?
Yeah.
Because he's not good enough to do anything else.
We start rehearsing in March. Now it's September and we've got to go to December.
Yes. It's not how it's
Thank you.
do I want this DVD to be? I've always hated live shows, hated live albums, hated live shows. I wanted to try and do this differently. I wanted it to be a real patchwork quilt of what it's, a little bit of what it's like. I didn't want some smooth, slick concert. I wanted more of the feel of the ramshackleness that it is every day, and the kind of brokenness of not knowing how it's going to sound on the stage and the changeability.
Yeah. dress.
I had enormous fun and I felt at one with myself in the world. And not an animal.
Look.
Oh. How did I get so drunk? What happened?
I'd say that was the tequila. And then have you been drinking wine as well, Polly Harvey?
You're not even on it.
Jesus.
I lost my heart under the bridge to that little girl. So much to me. That blue-eyed girl.
I feel like for the first time I'm getting somewhere close to the way I feel most comfortable with things. I think it takes years of learning what works, what doesn't work, having the confidence to actually make happen what you need to happen, and stand by it, because sometimes you have to fight your corner a bit to make sure that those things happen. And I think I've been more prepared to do that. I guess I'm talking about the way the tours run and being much more involved in the shows we're doing, knowing where they're going to be, how much we're playing, what the deal is with, you know, even just making sure there aren't adverts in the building that I don't want, and just overseeing the whole project, realising more that it's all a reflection on me, you know, the whole event. Every day is kind of the same. I have a slightly different dressing room, slightly different hotel, but there's certain things that are the same.
Shall we start?
Yes, please.
Lovely, let's have some of that big bass drum.
Big bass drum.
Keyboard going as well.
You're going to come to Jonathan Ross?
I'd love to.
I should do.
Is that the day after Hammersmith?
Yeah.
Do you know yet if you're playing or talking?
Just playing. So you're not famous enough to talk to Jonathan Ross.
Big my legs and I'm on fire. Lick sometimes it rains so hard. And I feel the hurt in my heart. It feels like the end of the world when I see the children, a shot.
Nicest group of people I've ever worked with.
Touring is great, I love it.
I don't think of it as being kind of like part of the circus arriving in town.
On a good day it's great, on a bad day it's not so great.
Love, peace, death metal, rock and roll, long hours.
It's hard work, easy work, boring, exciting. Any of those in any day.
It breaks you. And you have to put yourself together and then get started again. But it's all right, really. How's that?
Where are we? What day is it? What town are we in? What time sound check? About it, really.
The hour and a half that you're actually on stage is the best thing about being on tour. The other 22 and a half hours in the day are all revolving around getting to that one single hour and a half that you're actually doing it.
Just keep me burning, just keep me yearning for my home.
I've got to read this script by tomorrow.
This is Eric, and this is Eric. Look, two things the same.
is for London King's Cross via Cambridge.
Look who it is.
Look who it is.
How are you?
How are you?
No, how are you?
Look! Look, it's the star of the show. Point the camera at her instead.
Where?
Thank you.
looking beautiful.
Radiating, am I? Radiating. Yeah.
Yeah.
Did I just burn your head?
Every second you breathe.
highlights for me have always been when we're in a city where I've got friends and they might come up and play with us, because that just makes it really special and different and exciting for us.
You mustn't film me learning the songs while they're already on stage. That's Monster.
I think I'm more tired on this tour than I've ever been.
What is it like being in PJ Harvey?
It's fantastic. I get to do lots of drumming. Drumming all the time.
I love all the mess at the end.
The mess. That's great. No, where they sort of thought out, didn't they? But they just left it.
Thank you.
So yeah.
We've got a lady who's with the main act. She's got an Lexus laminated pass on, and she's got a video camera. She can film anywhere. She's going in and out of the auditorium and back here. Have you received that?
Yeah, I received that one.
What's touring like?
Yeah. It's not just surreal, it's just like being underwater.
It's eating your supper 2 hours later when it's not hot anymore.
It's definitely, for me, a sort of heightened state of anxiety and all the time, and I kind of feel like I become semi-illiterate and can't read and can't concentrate on anything, and it's just
so crazy.
Just yeah, I feel like I'm thick all the time.
It makes you in a state where you can't think of the answer to simple questions like that.
Confliction. We want to be doing this, but we never want to.
Thank you. that working?
Yeah.
No. Well, it's the end of this tour, and I'm feeling terribly sad, and it'll be awful just to say goodbye to all these lovely people. And, you know, I never ever want to see any of them ever again.
Good, because you won't.